initially we used to give 12.5 kilos per household when we do food distribution normally. However, now because of the situation, that portion has been upscaled to 25 kilograms of rice per household. And inshallah ta'ala, we plan to do another round after this one during this prolonged heat and dry spell that we are faced with. That is actually over 18 months long. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. We are here today to officially flag off countywide relief food distribution to the vulnerable destitute households that are suffering as a result of ongoing drought across all the six sub-counties in the county. The perennial drought has impacted negatively on the livelihoods of the pastoral communities in both urban and rural areas. In the week between 15th and 19th of November 2022, the county multi-sectoral technical officers led by the Special Programs Department conducted rapid needs assessment of the most vulnerable households across the six constituencies up to the village level. They identified around 45,665 households that are in dire need of humanitarian relief support as follows. Mandera North, 5,268. Kutulo, 2,643. Mandera South, 5,945. Mandera West, 4,113. Banisa, 5,607. Lafe, 3,069. Mandera East, 5,844. Among other identified groups that are in dire need of attention is registered orphanages, special schools, non-local personnel, people living with disability, internally displaced persons, fire victims, and mentally destitute households, all totaling to 13,176. These households, because of this situation, will each receive 25 kilogram bag of rice. Initially, we used to give 12.5 kilos per household when we do food distribution normally. However, now, because of the situation, that portion has been upscaled to 25 kilograms of rice per household. And inshallah ta'ala, we plan to do another round after this one during this prolonged heat and dry spell that we are faced with. That is actually over 18 months long. During this prolonged drought, we have upscaled our response and mitigation to drought by drilling and equipping 75 additional boreholes that are strategically located across the county. Also, our rapid response team has been effectively responding to borehole breakdowns as effectively as possible within a very short period of time. We are also planning to upscale the ECD school feeding program during this difficult time, and we will also do limited fodder distribution to the affected families, as well as food supplements to the livestock, limited food supplements. However, despite our response, we are not able to cope with this situation without external help, as this has been ongoing for over 18 months now. We therefore take this opportunity to appeal to the national government, especially Ministry of Devolution and Assals, His Excellency the President of the Republic of Kenya, and non-state actors to come to our aid, particularly in the provision of additional fodder and animal feed supplements, as well as complementing our relief food efforts and the emergency borehole repairs resulting from excessive use of the boreholes during this drought season. Since during a scarcity of resources, the inter-community tension is always very high during such time of scarcity of resources, I appeal to my population of Mandera to exercise tolerance at all times. We should all join hands in prayers to the Almighty Allah to save us from the current suffering as a result of ravaging drought that is really causing a lot of pain.